this form. My name is Meng Jiayan, and this is our team. We are from Horizon Robotics. We will talk about the techniques and approaches we used in the LFR challenge. And the topic of our report is what FaceNet, an efficient variable group convolutional neural network for lightweight face recognition. Okay, let's recall the requirements of the challenge. In a deep blue light track, the flops is required under 1G, and the model size is less than the 20 megabytes, and we use the limited training data, while we have 5,700 identities in the probe set and 1 million images in the destructor. So, to meet the requirements of the challenge and enhance the ability of our model, we use the variable group convolution to add the basic module to build our bug face net. So we will first introduce the variable group convolution, and then we will talk about the techniques and the settings in the bug face net. Finally, we will introduce the performance of the bug face net on the second generation of Sunrise. The second generation of Sunrise is the AI embedded chip designed by our company, which can support multiple computer vision tasks. Variable group convolution is proposed based on the two principles. The first one is the small intermediate future maps between blocks, and the second one is the balanced computational intensity inside the block. We can see from the left graph that the pipeline FPGAs and the ASICs is designed for the simultaneous implementations of competition and the data communication in a single operation. Using the fusion operation, we can afford the frequent data communication between on-chip buffer and off-chip DDR, since there is no intermediate results needed saved on the off-chip DDR. And the different operations can be concurrently executed by the different computation modules. The right graph shows the typical fusion operations. We can see from the kernel fusion that the horizontally adjacent layers share the same input fusion maps, which can suggest that we don't need to reload the input data. And the intermediate results of the vertical fused operations are just processed on the on-chip buffer. We can treat the fusion operation as a block. Therefore, the layers in a block are usually grouped and computed together to decrease data communication cost between the on-chip buffers and the off-chip DDRs. As a result, the off-chip memory and on-chip memory only communicates at the start or the end of the computing a block in the block. On-chip memory is needed to store the intermediate results. To deal with that, variable group convolution was proposed, which has fixed the ratio between input channels and the number of groups. The fixed ratio leads to the variable number of groups in different group convolutions. We named the fixed ratio as the group base. You can see from the table that when CI class 2 is much greater than the size of the kernel, the multi-ad discrepancy between the depth-wise convolution and the point-wise convolution is larger than that between variable group convolution and the point-wise convolution. Therefore, it will be more computationally balanced inside the block when it involves variable convolution instead of depth-wise convolution on the bottom of point-wise convolution. Since G, the group base, is greater than 1, variable group convolution has higher multi-path and larger network capacity than depth-wise convolution, which is capable of extracting more information. Okay, let's move on to our framework, bug facenet, which extends bugnet to large-scale face recognition tasks. First of all, we design a new type of embedding setting for lightweight face recognition tasks. A typical apps layer of embedding hosts match parameters and memory footprint, which can be shown in the table. To reduce the number of parameters and keep the discriminative and the generalization ability of embedding, we first import a 1x1 convolution to expand the number of channels to 1024. Then we import variable group convolution to reduce the spatial size of features while using point-wise convolution to fuse the information across channels. Finally, we can see that the F layer is stocked and just have 1 megabyte memory footprint. The overall memory footprint of this embedded setting is just 6.5 megabytes, but it can deal with large-scale face identification tasks. Besides embedding setting, we also import a new head setting, which keeps the spatial information of the images in the first convolution. And we add P-level and SE inside our blocks based on VagNet. And we can see that compared with VagNet, we have a better performance on LFI, LFW, CFP, and HDB tester. Let's talk about the loss we use. For open set tasks, scores are the logits of training set containing limited information of testing set, and the exact match of features may be over-regularized in some situations. So the normed features has been taken as a supervision of the destination, which is able to enhance the generalization ability of models. We use the equivalent version of angular discrimination loss, which is more convenient to implement. We import act-based loss as our classification loss. The overall loss is composed of act-based loss and angular discrimination loss. The alpha we used in the experiment is 7. Other than the angular discrimination loss, we also use a technique called the recursive knowledge discrimination. We import a teacher model during whole training. We take the student model of first generation to initial the second generation. It will be easier to approach guided direction of teacher when the initialization is applied. And the conflicts between the margin of classification loss and the guided angular information in the first generation will be relieved in the next generation. The second generation of recursive knowledge discrimination increased by 0.4%. So finally, we got 0.88784 on the Google Light Track. Now we will introduce the performance of the bug facenet on the second generation of Sunrise. The second generation of Sunrise supports multiple computer vision tasks, such as face-related tasks and audio-related tasks. Some data and demo of the second generation of Sunrise are shown on the screen. So the latency of our bug facenet is 5 ms on the second generation of Sunrise, which just uses one single core. Alex, thanks very much for the organization and the report. thanks very much for the help from our colleagues. The details will be included in our workshop paper, and the implementation of BACnet is released on